plus sigma of 4 pi u 4 pi pi sigma 4 pi into h value. Okay, and you need to remove the mode value as well. Let's see how to do the sums with this. First of all, let me write the median formula here because you're not a concept in this exercise. That is given as L plus n by 2, that is your half of your frequency minus cumulative frequency, F is your cumulative frequency divided by your frequency into H. Okay, so let's see how do we remove all these values and all. First of all, monthly consumption. That is your class interval, the frequency is your number of whatever it is, that is your 4, cutting 5, that is 13, 20, 14, 8 and a 4. So let me write this values also, 65, 85 to 105, 45 to 125, 125 to 145, 45 to 5, 165 to 5, 185 to 5. By looking at this, I can say that H is such as your required value. Okay, so let us remove this as mean value, whatever the frequency value over here. So for this, we need to be checking the frequency as maximum, that is your FS to be this one. Okay, now in a mode, you will be substituting this one directly. So the mode is your lower limiting value, the lower limiting value is 125 plus F1 minus F0, F1 minus F0, that is 20 minus 13. Let me write it over here. So value, this should be your F0, or this is F1, this is F2. You need to remember this by 2 into your F1, that is 40 minus 27 into H, I wrote it 20, right? So let me solve this. 125 plus, get here 7 is 7 into this comes out 140 by the remaining difference is 13. When I solve this, 125 plus, I need to add up with 10.7. The resultant is 135.7 as your required mode value. Okay, so let's see how do we do with the mean value here. Here the mean value is also same, the L value remains the same. Now N by 2. Now sigma of F of I is your required N value. Now when I am adding up the data already, you know what, when I add up, it's around 68. Okay. So here the frequency mode we have taken is 20 and again H value is 20. Okay, I hope I am clear up to here. Now N by 2 is your half of your frequency value, isn't it? So similarly means, ignore this one, let me see this one here. Cumulative frequency, just see here. Okay, look at this number 4, add this number with 5, the resultant is 9. Add this number with this one, the resultant is 22. Add this number with this number, the resultant is 42. Add this number with this number, the resultant is 56. Similarly, adding up these two comes out at 64. Similarly, adding up these comes out at 68. Comes out at 68. So here N by 2 is your 34. As I said that this is your value of N, so N by 2 is nothing but your 34. Okay, so that is your 34. Now, what is your cumulative frequency? Cumulative frequency is the value above this 22. Above frequency is your cumulative frequency. That is, this is your cumulative frequency. You need to take it. This as a cumulative frequency. So now substituting 125 plus, now solving up these two, one minimum comes to 12. So this 20, this 20 is similar. So we are left with 137 as your required median value. Okay, so that would be your required thing here. So I have done with mode also. Let's look at median now. I'm sorry, mean now. So let's look at mean. What is your xi? Xi is half of your CA value. So here, if I look at this, I get here 75, I get here 95, I'll be getting 115, here I'll get 135, here I'll get 105, here I'll get 175, here I'll get 195. There's no doubt about that one, right? So you also, you must have to so A by H. Again, A, you need to take the maximum value, that is your 100 as your A. So this is your 0, this is your minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 1, 2, 3. If you solve this, you will have this answer only. Now you need to do sigma f of I into u of I, that is f of I into this one. You need to put these two into here. Okay, so doing that, you'll get minus 2n. I'm getting here minus 30, getting 0, I'm getting 14, I'm getting 16, I'm getting 2n. Now sigma. Sigma of f of I into, oh sorry, 2 of I, that is, what is this? If I'm doing this one now, the result end of this one. I'm just substituting everything over here. I have assumed the value of this one as to be 135, right? Yes. Let sigma of 5, the result is 7.58 into h. H we are taking here 20. Okay, so this is 140. So the resultant of this one is quite simple. Let me write it over here. 135. Yes, when you're solving this, you are getting 0.1 something. So the resultant is 75.1 as your mean value. So if you're absorbing this one here, the mean mode and the mean values are approximately the same. So all these three values, whatever over here, are approximately the same. Okay, so just focus like that. So let's look at the next one. You need to remove here the value of x, and you need to remove the value of y also. You are having 60 observations as total. Okay, so here given the number of observations, that is sigma of f of I is your, okay, that'll give it. So this is your classical, this is your frequency, classical frequency 0 to 10, 5, 10 to 20, you are having x, 20 to 30, you are having 20, 30 to 40, you are having 50. 40 to 50, you have y. 50 to 60, you have pi. Okay, so if whenever you are using median, right, given over here, that is your cumulative frequency. I need to add this number up to here, 5 plus, add up these two, this is 25 plus x. Add up again this 30, 40, right? 40 plus x, adding up these two, that is 40 plus x plus y. Finally, adding up this 45 plus x plus y is your required answer. Okay. So, let us see how do we do this. The frequency of this one, we don't know the frequency. We assume any frequencies over here. We cannot assume any frequencies over here. So, let us solve this. Directly, okay. Here, median. What he has given here is the median. Okay, median, as you all know, that median m is equal to l plus psi 2 minus f by f into. Okay, so let's see how do we do this from here. See, if you're looking at the last one, he says that the overall frequency, that is, this 2 needs to be equal all the time. That is, 45 plus x plus y equals to 60. Now, when I am repeating this number over the other side, x plus y equals to 60 minus 45. So, I have left with x plus y equals to 50. So, x plus y equals to 50. Let this be your equation number 1. Okay. And so, let's look at the formula. 28.5 is given as a median of this sum here, and I'm assuming the lower limiting in the given frequencies, this is a higher frequency, so I need to that, and this as your lower limiting value L, that is L is your 20, plus n by 2. If you look at n by 2, that is off of n is 30 only, right? Minus cumulative frequency is 5 plus x. So this is 5 plus x, right? By f value, we have taken it as 20 as it is the highest value, and this is your h value 0, 0, remove it directly. Let's look at this 28.5 equals to 20 plus 30 minus 5 minus x equal to. I'm shifting this to here so that this is sorts out equally, so that it's around certain here. Let us solve this. I'm shifting this 20 here. I am left with only, when I'm shifting the 20 here, 28 point minus 20, how by getting it equivalent to 25 minus x by 2. Now this is 8.5 is left out equals 5 by 2. Shifting this number here, 8.5 into 2 equals to 25 minus x. So this becomes almost 17 minus 25 equivalent to x. So here x is equal to, what is the result? X is equal to 8 is your answer. So similarly, you need to remove. So here I have the x value as 8. So what about this value? So for substituting the value of y, to get the value of y, substitute x in equation number 1. Then I'll get 8 plus y equals to 15. I'm shifting this 8 the other side, 15 minus 8. So at last, y equals to 7 is your required answer. So I can say that at last, y equals to 7 is your required answer. Okay, so you are having here 100 policies. Calculate the median age. Policies are given only to the persons having 18 to 60 years is your age limit. So here also you are having 60 and here below this one, right? Okay, let's see. You need to remove here what median. As you all know that median is given by the formula median. This is given by the formula lower limiting value plus n by 2 minus c here to by your frequency. Let's see. This is your age, that's a cumulative frequency, and this is your number of folders, that is your f value. Right? So let me write the f value: 2, 6, 24, 45, 7, 8, 89, 98, 89, 92, 98, and 100. Here, age below, that is less than 20, right? You need to maintain the class intervals as you should require the lower limiting values. So, I'll take it here. See here, it is below 25. So I can write 20 to 25 here and 25 to 30 here, 30 to 35 here, 20, 35 to 50 here, 40 to here, 45 to 50 here, 50 to here. As we are ending with the 60 only because the next one for the request is 55 only, right? So 60 is the last one. Okay. I hope I'm clear up to here, right? So if you're looking at this frequency, this itself is your 100 value. Means this is not your reference, this is your cumulative frequency. This is your cumulative frequency. So from this cumulative frequency, you need to remove the data. How do you remove the data using this? Look at this number, you can write this 2 here. You need to do these two subtractions, then you will get here 4. Okay, so then you will be getting here 4, right? These two, I'm getting here 6. When I'm subtracting these two, what I'm getting? 3. Subtracting these two, I'm getting 7. When I'm subtracting these two, 78 minus 48 is to a 33. Now when I'm subtracting these two, I'm getting 20. Subtracting these two, I'm getting 18. Subtracting these two, I'm getting 4. And there's some subtraction here, it's only 2. So this is how you will be removing the frequency value. When you remove the frequency value, you are able to observe that this f of value, right? So the cumulative frequency, you know that this is your n value, right? This is your n value, and you know that this is your n value inside of f, right? And adjacent to that one is your cumulative frequency. That is adjacent to that one is. So let me substitute everything in the formula, that is 75 plus 2. So let me substitute everything in the formula 35 plus n by 2. N is your 100, that is 100 by 2 is your 50. Minus cumulative frequency 45. Right? 33 into the difference is how much? The difference is only 5. Yes, the difference is only 5. So here I can write 35 plus 5. So 5 by 33. By 33. Here 35 plus 25 by 33. Now when I am dividing 25 by 33, this 25 is divided by 30. Right? So keeping on 0 here, one more dot over here. So 7s are. I will be dividing this one using, that is 22. I will be getting whatever is left out. I think 4 would be your lifting out, that is your 9, that is 290. I think this comes 5 times, right? So at last, this division is 35 plus 0.75. So at last, the answer is 35.75 is the required median value. Hope this sum is clear to everyone. Right, so let's look at the next sum. This is your fourth sum. So this is your fourth sum. Let's see how to do the fourth sum. Given length. Okay, how do I write it as equal? What I'll do is I'm subtracting 0.5 from the lower interval and I'm adding the same number to the upper interval. Am I clear? So here I'm subtracting 0.5 on the LHS side, and on the RHS side I'm adding whatever I have subtracted, so that the interval remains the same. So here when I do the same thing over here, now what happens here is I am getting a regular class interval. There is no difference between the class intervals. The regular class interval is maintained. Just to subtracting here, look at this one. That one. So, subtracted 0.5, I'm adding 0.5 to 100. Thirdly, in the next one also, I'm just subtracting that from 100. So, this becomes a number. This becomes constant. Right? And eventually, this one also comes like this. Do what is required. Right? So, the next is your frequency. So, let's look at this. Let me write the frequency. Which way given here directly. Okay, so you need to write the cumulative frequencies also. 3 adding to 5 here comes out 8, adding up this comes out your 17 is added up to your 12, that comes out your 20, add up your 38, and the next is your 40, which is your required one. Okay, so if you are looking at over here, this is your maximum frequency. Yeah, the above one is your CF. The left one is your L value, and H you can remove it directly. So here the more the median, here the median is equivalent to L value L plus by 2 minus F by F into L value is 144.5 plus 20 minus this is your required N value. Half of that is your 20. CF is your 17 by F is 12 into the H value is your difference 9. Okay, so the difference is 9. So when I'm solving this, 144.5 plus 3 by 4 into 9. So here, so this is your 12, right? Now, when I'm dividing this, this comes 4. Now, 144.5 plus 9 by 4. So when I'm dividing those two here, I'm left with 0.2 something. The answer is 146.7 millimeters. It is the required median length. It is your required median. I hope I'm clear with this. So let's look at the next one. Find the median life time of a lamp. I think this one can be done in an easy way. Let me write the formula. Median is equivalent to L plus N by 2 minus F by F. Let me write the class time, that is your class intervals, and this is your cumulative frequency added up. Here, what can I write? I'm writing 1000 to 2500. We need to add up these values. This is your class intervals. These are the class intervals. Let me write this. 6 of 6, 40. Now you need to add the cumulative frequency. So by doing that, if I have this, right? This is 9. Fingers come. Okay, so this is your n value. So what is 6 by equal n? So if you look at the maximum frequencies, the frequency maximum this. So this should be a limiting frequency, and the above one should be. I'm just substituting everything in the formula. Then I'll have n by 2 as 200. So because n is 400, cumulative frequency is 130, by f value is 86, and this value is 500. Okay, so let's solve this one. This is your 3000 plus 70 by 86 to 500. Okay, now dividing, doing this two into and then dividing here, I'll get 3000 plus 406.9. Now adding up these two, 3406.9 is your required lifetime pass. I hope I'm clear with this one as well. Yeah. The code of the given data. So let's write everything separately. I'm writing here the mean, I'm taking here the assumed mean so that we can solve it quite quickly. So that would be your mean area and that is your mode area, median area, right? Let me write here mode. That is your L plus F minus F naught by 2. Okay. And what is the median formula? L plus N by 2 F by F. So this is your in formula. So flexibility as I'm substituting them. This is your class interval, that is I'm taking 10, 13, 30, 90. This is your frequencies. 4, 4, 3, 3, and your 6. So this is your given frequency. Yeah. So let me write the cumulative frequency first. So 6 here. So this 6 would be how much? So this got to be 7, 6. This is your 92. Right. So sigma of 5 is 100.
Right, so what more, so let me substitute it over here. When I see this frequency, this, so this will be your cumulative frequency, your L value, isn't it? So I'm just substituting everything over here. 7 plus n by 2 is your minus 36 by f value is 40, and the difference value is 3, h value is 3. So 7 plus, now when I'm subtracting these two over here, right, this and this 3 is ignored here, this is 40. So 7 plus 40 into 3, 42 by 40. So you are getting 1 point something, right? Yes, you will get 1.05. When I add up this, 8.05 is a required median value. Okay, so that would be your required median value. I think we can directly substitute more value also here, right? So the more lower limiting term is 7. Now I'm taking this one as f1, this as f0, this as your f2. That has to be your f2. So when I'm taking this, I can write here 40 minus 30 by 2 into f1, that is your 80 minus 30 minus 16 into 3 again. When I solve this, I'll get 7 plus n by 30. Oh wait, minus only, right? Yeah, 80 minus 46 into 3. So what I'll get 30 by 80 minus 46, this comes out to be 34. Now when I'm dividing this, I'll get 7 plus 0.8 roughly, that is 7.8 roughly, which approximately is equal to 8. So let us remove this one here. I get sigma of f of t. Now I should get the deviation, that is di. Di is xi minus a, if you are remembering it, right? So let me take the a value as xi. I need to remove the xi also, right? The xi value of this one. So the class intervals of this one is 2.5. We'll get here 5.5. Next is 8.5. And next is 11.5. The next is 14.5, is around 7. So this is your highest frequency, the parallel one is your A value, so this would be your 0. Now this would be your minus 3, this is plus 6, 3 is 6, and this would be your 9, alright. That would be your 9. Now f of I into d of I need to do, this is for f of I, so this is d of I, right? This becomes minus of 6, this is 90, this is 0, this is 48, this is 0. Should be 36, right? Now, f of I into d of I in this, so the result is minus 8. So, just substituting it over here, a value is how much? That's your assumed 8.5. Yes, that is minus 18 for the da by sigma of I is right? And so, when I do this one directly here, I'll get 8.5 minus 0.18, so that would come out 8.3. So all of them are approximately equivalent, isn't it? So I think this would be the last exercise of the sum. So let's see. This is your weight given over here, class interval. So you can see you should get a little bit as you refer to the median. Only median is given as L plus N by 2, N by 2 minus CF by F into H. The class interval here is 40 to 40. If I, that is 2 to 3, if I to 3, 5, if I to 3, 6, 5, if I to 70, 5, this is 2, this is 3, 6, 6, and 8, 3, 2. So the cumulative frequency here is 2, adding up 5, adding up is your 13. Adding up this 15, adding up this 5, adding up this 28, adding up 30. Similarly, let me get the highest frequency value. The highest frequency came over here is 8. So this is your 8. So this is your 4. Corresponding is your L value. So 50 plus n by 2 is your 15 minus cumulative frequency is 5 by 8 into, if you look at the difference for 6, right? Yeah. So the difference is to 6. Okay. This is your 6. I am taking the class number as 2x, okay? So here 50 plus, so this becomes 10 into 5, 8, isn't it? So here I am left with 50 plus 60 by 8. 60 by 8, so when you are dividing this, you get 7.5 approximately. Okay? So this is your median weight. So this is the median. That's good. This one. So I hope I'm clear.